Hello everyone, and welcome to the last game of the last Armory event I participated. Until now, I am at like 2 wins and 1 loss, and this is the final match before the finals. I'm playing against the Naira. This is the person that was first until now in the tournament. He had no loss, so I was a bit, you know, skeptical because. I think I do not have it. From what I remember from this match, this is an important match that I show you because it shows how important is the first turn. And it shows that you need to know when to go aggressive and when to play more passive in the first turn in order to maximize the effectiveness of your aggression. So in this matchup, I don't know if I would win if I played the first turn differently, but it certainly made me be at a disadvantage on the entirety of the game after that. So let's see what happens. My opponent, I won the road and I decided that I would go first. And as I have mentioned before, in general, when I go first, I want to play very passive. I want to create a runechant, put the card in arsenal, and that's all. But as you will see in a bit here, I had a very strong hand, and I got myself carried away. Here, as you can see, I'm not choosing Husk because Era is a go wide deck. And I think that Husk is not that necessary here. So yeah, here we roll. I win the roll by one. It's the first roll I win in this tournament. And I decide that I should go first. So we draw. And as you can see here, I have an amazing, amazing turn. The thing is, and I should have kept this exactly amazing turn for later. For the next turn, because now he would be able to defend against almost everything and not be at a severe disadvantage. So here you can see, I do what I should, I banish 3 cards, I gain 3 resources with Soul Reaping, and I'm gonna play both Seeds of Agony, which is a yellow and a red, both apply to Rift Bind. You can see here he defends against this for 6, and I'm like, nice, now I think I can be aggressive and deal some damage. So here I see that I only need 1 resource. So I create a runechant. I play seeds, and I'm attacking for 5 plus 3 arcane essentially. And I'm thinking, yeah, I can do some damage here, but he decides to do the correct choice and pitch 3, defend against their king, defend against another 3, so he only takes 2 damage. So here, look at this. I had an amazing hand. I had a very aggressive turn. I attacked for like 6 damage from Soul Reaping, 3 more arcane, 9, and 5 from this, 14 damage. 14 damage in my first turn. That would be amazing. How much damage did I did? Only 2. And he would, in every other turn, he would have no hand or he would have taken a ton of damage. But in this, because it's my first turn, he draws back to 4 and it's like 2 damage. It's okay. It's okay, bro. What should I have done? pitched message of Falcon, create a runechant. And then arsenaled my shadow ripping. Doing that, I would have a very, very strong third turn. Essentially, second turn for me, third total turn of the game. And I would apply a lot of pressure. I should have created it. I did create, but in the turn I said that I should have created a chain as well. In bridge, you every turn you want to create a chain, even if you do not get any use by it, you want to create a chain because it is essentially a draw. So here, if I did like I said my last turn, and I had pitched Siege of Agony to create a runechant and arsenaled my sword ripping, I would have one Siege of Agony in my hand, the red one. A Rift Bind and Shadow of Usur plus Bounding Demigod, which would be the nuts with Sword Ripping. I would banish everything from my hand, gain 4 resources, and would be able to play. No, I would not buy Bounding Demigod because I would need it to use. I would have 3 resources and use Shadow of Usur to banish Bounding Demigod in order to give it go again like this. So I would have an amazing turn. And he would not be able to defend everything, or he would have no hand next turn. So, yeah. Losing Sword Ripping without either his costing his hand or doing a ton of damage is not worth it. So, here what happens? I misplay once again. What happens here is that I did not defend any of the Kadats. Kadats, I don't remember. Harmonites. His weapon attacks, anyways. And I forget about the mask. So I essentially give him one draw for free. Even though he won't get to use that much, because he would arsenal one and draw four in this case, but if he draws now one, it would be. He would arsenal one card and draw three. It's still bad to forget this. So now I use my equipment to defend some damage. I miscalculated here, I took more damage than needed. Here, to be honest, I'm like, why did he draw one card? What happened? And he reminds me of the mask. Yeah, exactly. So here's the new card. That's the old card, okay. And he passed right back to me. So in this case, it did not. The mask did not help him. He might have helped me if the new card would be a defense reaction, for example, and he would have arsenal that. So here I banish one. It's amazing that I drew a Siege of Agony. Always nice to see them. But unfortunately, I can use Shadow of Usur here, banish Bounding Demigod, and then use my Siege of Agony with Bounding Demigod. I think that's an easy turn. It's not the best, but it's quite good. Exactly, what I'm doing here is pitch Razor Reflex because I do not plan to use it. Yeah, I did the miscalculation before, as I mentioned. I got confused by his draw, and he mentioned something in the game that made me think that I defended for less. So I took one more. It was an accident by me. By no way I wanted to cheat or anything. He reminds me he I mis I calculated once again and see that I should be at 14. So I correct it. In this case right here reveal this. So he takes one arcane. He should take one arcane. And I may banish it, but I should not banish this card because there's no point. So here, he sees the Siege of Agony as well. So he's like, yeah, I'm gonna pitch because I want to protect against Siege of Agony as well. That's a clever move from my opponent. So now what I'm gonna do is play Shadow Forger. Banish Bounding Demigod. Give it go again. So in this case, as you can see, I want to use Chane, even though it will go to waste later on, as I won't have any more attack actions to do. I should use Chane right here exactly because I need to have more cards and banish on later. So after I use Siege of Agony, I should use Chane to give Bounding Demigod go again and let the go again go to waste. Doesn't matter. So I'm attacking with Shadow Forger here. My opponent is gonna defend, as it seems, for two. Play Siege. Use Chane exactly like I mentioned before. Use Bounding Demigod for one arcane, which he can defend without needing to spend any more cards, plus 3 attack. Exactly. And he takes it. So here, what do I have in my hand? I have a pretty good hand. I would like a bit more pitch value, if possible. So he attacks me with Nourishing Emptiness. It doesn't have the secondary effect because, yeah, but he has plus one from this. So I'm gonna defend for two. Yeah, and as I thought, I would defend with the Fate Foreseen as well. I took two. I banished two cards. One is out of war, which always hurts to see that go there, and one is unhallowed, right? So, what should I do here? This is a bit difficult because piercing Shadow Eyes costs two. The effect is may be activated with Dimensional Gateway, but I have not enough pitch value to use. And this is a bit strange what I do here. So, what I think I should do is pitch Piercing Shadow Eyes because to use it right here and take advantage of it is very, very hard. So yeah, I'm playing Shadow Puppetry. I'm pitching this. I give go again to my unhallowed rites. So I think this play was A bit of a mistake here. And I'm gonna explain why. So, what I discovered here. Maybe a better move. Now, I am not able to use dimensional gateway anyway. So he defends against this. I gain 2 resources. Yeah. No, this is a decent move right here. What do I do here? I do not have a shadow rotate, which I would be able to play easily. And I would have that one more resource in order, for example, to banish, cost the visit, use chain, give it go again, and then attack with my galaxy black. But I think I'm gonna risk it. Yep, put it on the bottom, put this on the top. Okay, I repeat it. I say, yeah, take one arcane. My opponent checks my resources. He wants to see what I may do next. He knows that I'm gonna attack with Galaxy, with Galaxy Black. He takes the arcane, and then I'm gonna use chain because I want to use chain, not because it's relevant here. And I'm gonna attack with Galaxy Black. He defends against it, and I end my turn. As you can see here, the IRA player is playing the long game as he should be doing. I stole his card somehow. I don't know how this bug happened. I give it back to him. So he's attacking with his harmonized Gandaches. I take it. It's a single attack. I block against it, but this is a wrong block because it still hits and mask is something to be afraid of. Especially since he has one more pitch and the tunic. So I should have blocked the first Gandache. To be honest, that's what I'm thinking here, that I do not fully block, and I would like to fully block. So, what I do here is, you know what, I'm gonna defend with my two equipment, which is very bad. It's not a great move here. Because I want to keep my one defense from my equipment to block the first attack with Kodachi, which deals with just one. So here I banish 3, 1, 2, 3. So what do I see here? I see that I want to use Siege of Agony to enable both Bounding Demigod and Rites, Unhallowed Rites. So I don't want to pitch that. Because otherwise I'm taking 2 blood debts and I'm losing some pressure. So the next best thing to pitch is Vexing Madness and once again pitching Shadow Vice, which once again does not help here. That's why I took them out of the deck. I use Chain. Attack with Bounding Demigod. He takes their arcane damage and defends for 4. these physics decks are very annoying. So I use my... I have no resources, I'm gonna... Vexing Man is here. And here, because he took the Arcane, it's a very good time to use Shadow Piercing Vice. But I'm using my one resource, sorry for this. So yeah, I take my Siege of Agony back. Always good to see that. I'm attacking for 4 here. And I have one resource left. Which is a bit annoying because I would love to use Piercing Shadow Vice since he took the arcane damage finally. So what I should do here is maybe use Snapdragon to give go again. And then beats the Bounding Demigod to attack with Piercing Shadow Vice. It's not the most efficient play, but I think it's the best play I can do right now. So he takes it. I use the Snapdragons. Yeah, I use it on my attack reaction. And I'm attacking with the Bounding Demigod. Okay. I think that's a bad move. But I get to Arsenal one card, which is okay, I guess. But still not great. Yeah, I think I should have attacked with Piercing Shadow Vice. Here he's using his mask to defend, which is good for me because it's gone, and I don't have to worry about it. And I pass up my turn back to him. And I think I misplayed here as well. So here finally I have some great pitch values. Have 2/3. And 1/2. I think though that I need to defend against what's coming because I'm afraid he's gonna come a bit dangerously. And he starts with a lightning strike. I don't remember which effect he used, to be honest. But he also has his Snapdragons to activate even if he used the +2. I'm still afraid of the go again. So before, when I said he takes it and I used my Snapdragons, I essentially, he said no blocks, that he takes it, and he took it before I could go to reactions. But yeah, he knows that I have I activated it on my reaction. Yeah, as you can see here, during his reaction, he activates the Snapdragon, I activate this. Art of War goes to the bottom, of course. I saved one Art of War from getting banished. I take, and he attacks with Command and Conquer, which is annoying. I don't really mind losing this card, but I need to defend because I'm at 6. I take 3, but as you can see, the game does not go well for me from here on out. No, sorry, I take 4. It's his second attack. That's why I take 4. He's at 8 life. I still need at least 2 turns to be able to kill him, and I don't think I have 2 turns, especially with the hand I have right now. So let's see what I... Banish here, a bunch of Vexing Maldis, a Razor Reflex, a Rift Bind, and a Shadow Forcer. Yeah, this is not a good banish zone with the current hand that I have. Before, When I was blocking, I blocked with a 3 pitch value of Vexing Body instead of my red pitch. Which is the wrong move, because now I would love to play Mothrim Skies to be able to apply a bit more pressure with my Rift Bind. But I have to pitch it. I have to pitch it to be able to play Shadow of Culture and Drift Bind. And I won't be able to play Vexing Mantis because I won't have enough go again, because I can't activate Usur effect. So yeah, this turn would be much better if my Vexing Mantis would be the blue one, the blue pitch one, instead of the red one. It would make all the difference. So yeah, I'm using Chain, attacking with Shadow of Usur. We'll go again from Chain. He just blocks one. Yeah. Now what am I gonna do? I'm just, I mean, just attacking with Rift Bind is not great. I do not have a great move here. That's very, very annoying. So I use Mavrion Skies, give go again, yeah, pitching and attacking with Rift Bind. I'm attacking for 4 with go again. And if it hits, I create a Rujan, but I have no more resources. So I can't do anything with my go again. He defends. I do not create the Rujant. I draw 4. As you can see here, my deck is getting very, very thin. So he attacks with the Kadachis. I do not have the... I would take the one, I think. Yeah, but I have to block the next two. I'm gonna block with an Artite Thunderer, which is in my deck only and only because of Prism. And he attacks with a 5 attack power, which really messes me up. Yeah, I have to defend against this with 2 cards from my hand. So now I just have a Blue Siege of Agony. And I must banish 5 cards. One is this, 2 is this. Yeah, I lose from that for sure. Because I either play Siege of Agony to be able to play Bounding Demogorgon, and oh no, yeah, now that saves me. That literally saves me. But still, it's a lost cause, I think. I mean, yeah, Siege of Agony, use Chain, I guess. Yep. Attack with Bounding Demogorgon for 3+1. I do not have enough to put enough pressure on him. Not by long shot. And this is because I did not manage to put enough pressure on the beginning, even though I could with the hand that I drew. And he did put more pressure on me. He defended very cleverly, and I did not manage to essentially put enough pressure. So yeah, I created a rune shot with my remaining 2 resources. It's the best I can do. So yeah, I'm attacking for 4 if it's a red cost of visit, I do not see clearly, and 1 arcane. He takes the arcane, flick flag defense. Those flick flags are very annoying. So he's at 5 life. I draw 4. And I have 3 more cards in my deck. So he attacks for 1, I have to defend against everything. I have no equipment, so I have to use every card in my hand. I defend with shields. He attacks with this, which is, yeah. But he has no resources left. So he can't essentially kill me, but I have to use everything in my hand, essentially, to defend against this. So now I banish 6 cards. I banish 3 cards essentially, because yeah. Which is just a Siege of Agony. And I lose. Yeah. No coming back from that. I forfeit here. I could use the Siege of Agony and stay alive, not die from blood debt, but it's still no point on that. I would have no cards in hand. So yeah, a good game from my opponent. He played really well. I went 2-2. I did not go to the finals. And that was all for this Armory event. I would play a new one in this Sunday. I may upload some games from that one as well. I will continue playing Chane. I also have Crashing Constructed with Chane that I may upload as well before the tournament on Sunday. And I hope you enjoyed and learned something. I think that today's video was quite educational on when to go aggressive on your first turn and when not. And this was a bad choice to go aggressive, especially against Naira, which she can easily defend against my aggression. And I essentially did not punish her defense because it was the first turn of the game. So hope you have fun, hope you liked it, and see you on my next video. Bye bye.